She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was counting up like last week. Tell me, where have you been?
Yeah, came out of that. Yo, what is up? I'm back with another video. I know it's been a while, but you know, to be fair, I did warn you guys, I don't really post that often, so I'm more active on TikTok, and even then I don't really post that much, but today I got a package, and as you guys can tell by the title, it is a 1992 vintage, like, it's like a vintage Goku, like a vintage Goku stuffed animal, so let's open it right now. I need to get my pocket knife, I don't know where it is. Okay, never mind, anyways. Alright, so this plush is from 1992. It is a vintage one. I got two of them. This is the second one that I ordered, but it came here earlier because it's in the US. The other one was in Thailand, so I'll have to make another video on that one if it's here. But alright, let's get to opening this. So basically, I got into Dragon Ball not too long ago, and I looked on eBay to see if they had any cool Dragon Ball stuff. Because, you know, whenever I get into something, I always see if there's, like, cool things that go along with it or whatever. But I ended up finding this, and I looked further into it, and I realized that there's an old set of Dragon Ball stuffed animals that are, like, vintage and stuff. And I've seen a couple listings on eBay for them. But, yeah, here's the one that I got. Here's the second one. This is the Goku vintage 1992 stuffed animal, and I got this one because he was like $15, and honestly he doesn't really look too bad. I mean, face is spot on, and it looks really nice. Like, the mouth is good, everything about him is good. And I got him because he was like kind of scuffed up here, and just like he looks kind of dirty, so I wanted to clean him up and stuff. And you know, again, if I said it right, he was only $15 with free shipping, so that's pretty cool. And just to think that, you know, he's a vintage plush from 1982 for $15 free shipping, like, how am I not gonna do that? But yeah, here's how it looks in my hand. Honestly, he's pretty big plush for like $15. I thought he was gonna be kind of smaller than this, but yeah, it's pretty cool. I'll show you other pictures of the, I'll show you pictures of the other ones that were on, or that were listed on eBay, because the other ones kind of look like wonky, they kind of look wonky and stuff, and I don't know, I'm like kind of picky with like certain plush and everything like that, because like if the stitching is kind of messed up here and the eyes are kind of lopsided, like, you know what I mean, that type of thing. But oh wait, he has a tag down here, I didn't even see that. Anyway. Yeah, the tag's still on it, which is kind of surprising. Camera would focus on it. Come on. I hate this so much. Hold up. Yeah, you get the point. I mean, it's there. It says Bandai on it. Bandai 1992. It was made in Japan. And then it has some, like, Japanese wording on the back. Or, like, I don't know. Yeah, it's pretty cool. But, yeah, like, I don't know, just want to make an unboxing or, like, unwrapping, whatever you want to call it. Because this is pretty cool. And I'm probably gonna, like, have this one on the next one that I do, because whenever that one comes in, I'm just gonna compare the two. Because honestly, okay, I'm gonna go more in depth, because I feel like I kind of just like explained it all too quickly in like a couple minutes. So basically, I got this one because I wanted to clean it up and like make it look good again, because the other one that I had ordered was like $38 or something like that, and it looked pretty much like mint. And there's couple visible things, like the thing right here, his symbol is kind of faded away. I was thinking I could like draw it back on or something like that, but yeah, like other than that, like his face is just, everything's perfect about him, just he needs to be cleaned, that's pretty much it. But yeah, there's the back of him, there's front of him, side profile, other side. don't know. I just really like how they did the look with this one. Like, his hair is just up here. Like, his hair looks really good. Because that's another thing with all the Dragon Ball plushes that I've seen on eBay. All of them have, like, kind of wonky hair. And, like, that's one of his main, like, that's one of Goku's main things. It's his hair. So, if you're able to get it, like, spot on and just make it look good with this type of format, then, yeah, it's awesome. But, yeah, this is the 1992 Dragon Ball Z Goku plush. So, yeah. Okay, so basically, I'm gonna just add this clip onto the current video that I already made. But the second one arrived. So, I'm going to open this one. And, yeah, I mean, it's basically the same thing. So, I'm not really gonna go too into depth about it. But I am kind of confused why they put it in a box. I think it would be better that they put it in a bag like the other one. But yeah, before I open this, I am going to take this one over here for reference because that'd be smart to send it to you. Yeah, this box got beat up. I don't understand why they would put it in a box. Bro, he's all smushed, bro. It's not what I wanted him. I don't want him to be smoosh. Alright, he looks like the pictures though, so that's all I care about. Look. Dang, look at him, bro. Bro, his head, bro. His head looks so smoosh. He had to fit him. They just smushed him in there, bro. I don't know why they would do that. But, here, let me open it. Freaking weird packaging. Okay, he's definitely a bit more soft. He feels a bit more soft than the other one. I don't know, there's really nothing noticeable about, like, because this one has a couple of scuffs on it. Like, this one has a couple of scuffs on it. But this one is just like, there's not really much. But this one definitely looks different. He looks a little bit like more scrunched. And this one looks a bit more stretched. But even then, they're still the same thing. Like, he has more of a straight face. And he's like, raising an eyebrow at you for some reason. But yeah, here they are. They're the same thing. Just a lot of different aspects on certain things. Like the eyes, the eyebrow I just mentioned, the mouth. Just their facial expression looks different too, because he looks kind of depressed while he looks kind of like he's up to something, you know what I mean? I don't know. But yeah, like, just with certain details, like the little emblem right here, this one's, it's like not faded, not as faded as this one is. But yeah, it is pretty cool, pretty cool. I will put them side by side, or at least try to. But yeah, that's how they look side by side. Yeah. I really don't know why I ordered two. I feel like this one was $15, like I said, so I just got this one for, like, whatever, because, you know, I already had to pay, like, 30-something for this guy. And honestly, he's really soft. I'm pretty sure this one's, like, probably mint condition. But, yeah, like, I can kind of see, like, not even kind of, I can just definitely see the differences with these two, because this one looks more mint. And this one looks a bit more used, and he feels a bit more worn, which it doesn't really matter, because they're freaking amazing. So, yeah, I don't really have too much in my Dragon Ball collection. Like, I wouldn't even say I have a Dragon Ball collection, because I only have, like, these two Goku plush that I have. And then, like, what I have, hold on. There's this thing I keep in my backpack. I keep a Dragon Ball in my backpack. Has like the three stars on it. It's a three-star Dragon Ball. So I have the three-star Dragon Ball. Like, I, you know what? I'm gonna just gather up all my other Dragon Ball things that I have in here. Cause I have a couple, like, and I just started watching Dragon Ball like a week or two ago. I have this Super Saiyan Blue Goku action figure. I've had this one for a while. I've had like two Super Saiyan Funko Pops for a long time. This one, This one my grandma actually got me from like Vegas. She went to Vegas one time and they had it in like one of the gift shops or whatever. But yeah, it was pretty cool. And I'm pretty sure one of the other ones I have is like deep in there. I don't really want to try and find it in there, so yeah. I also have this Gohan. It's like Gohan Burger King toy. I didn't even know it was Gohan. I knew it was from Dragon Ball. I just didn't know what character it was until I actually watched the series. But yeah, those are a couple things I've got. Oh yeah, I was forgetting the energy drink. My brother got me a Dragon Ball Spirit Bomb energy drink. And I've seen this one around at like FYE and stores like that in the mall and stuff. I just never bought it because, you know, I'm not really one for energy drinks, but the designs on the cans look really cool. I think that's all the Dragon Ball stuff I own. And, you know, this collection's only gonna get bigger and bigger, so whatever new stuff that I get, I will let you guys know. But, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Fly away.